going to God is good about you. Are you God now? Are you going to bless us? So if we do this every semester and we put all this together, every 3 years is for people to be blessed and we value you. You will know that you must teach because you do not teach, you are in trouble. So this is what I'm talking about. There has to be some of this as part of the orientation that we must have in this. The last one is about the attitude of discussion against okay. Yeah, I agree. And Mr. Captain Sobeo Jimo, is absolutely right. If you want to do the right thing, because you're a scientist. You know, let him go. Just give him a note. Let him go. Why he made the boy, the poor boy. The boy suddenly become poor. Poor boy. Why he made the boy again? Just let that go. And if you look at those who are saying that they are your colleagues, you know, I think it is the institution that must take its time. The institution has to have a requirement, a criteria, clearly stated. An institution must not be ambiguous about it. Very far about it. That if you do not achieve this standard in your research, you cannot graduate. For that, when you now try to enforce it, and somebody is going to talk, you can always refer them to the institution. That's number one. Number two, what's your own morality? Are you afraid of this, your friends? Or you are afraid of your own conscience between you and your work? If this person has not worked, and you are in and in because your friends have sent them to school, you think that is the end of the story? You know, you are going to be answerable to God Almighty. Everything you do, even teachers, you think you are helping, but you are not helping. But you know what is even worse? You have also cheated your conscience. Because every little thing like this, these are things that come together to build the nation. Everything you do that, you are watering down on the quality of this country. That's what we're doing. That's why we are all puppets in the destruction of this nation. Teachers play a major role in it. Thank you.
Okay. Let me do this. Because from what we have now, we just have about another 18 minutes. We'll see how we manage it. Can I get the hands of people who want to further engage our distinguished guest lecturer today? Just put up your hands. Let me know for how many people we are. Put up your hands. Put up your hands. Two, go. Alright, so we'll give time for these two people to ask the questions.
Permit me to adopt the assistant protocol to our honorable guest speaker, Professor Nahanda. You've handled a topic of discussion.
Introduce yourself.
Oh, I'm Olatunji Akeha from Languages. Find a topic, an issue, a team. We've actually undergone a 2 month lecture. I want to say that we're thanking entirely appreciate you for this effort. My comment, this is more of a comment, please. And you've actually thought of my desire in the idea of orientation. It's about mentorship, which you mentioned in your discussion. The issue of mentorship has gone a long way to affect our growth, our morale, and development. In the past, you have models, and your model shapes your life. But as you move on, this is right from home. Parent kills the children's strengths, moral interests, and desires. But I want you to be overprotective, and as a result, leadership and followership have come to a very bad situation and extent. The leader sits in several aspects as the superior. The followers are not submissive, after submissive, but they don't really adhere to the rules of positions. And as a result, nobody wants to come down to follow the normal norms and values. How do you go about this situation? Your man has gone a long way to affect your profession. If you are properly upright, sincerely, your professional status will keep. So how do you go about actually giving a orientation and a reprimand to this emergency? Thank you.
I am Dr. Salman Tawasulisa, HOD in Peter's House. Well, I notice the distinct way of looking at this problem. And I think we need to start thinking of the holistic model that will actually capture every component that our education system needs. For example, we have just highlighted the defects that we have in our city. Who are that in community? Education must be owned by everybody. Until when we are on the same page, we may not make achievement. So my take is that can't we start working on a model where everybody will be on the same page? We tell ourselves the truth and everybody start running according to each other. Like there's no another crime. You are giving us a model of the institution. Or I'm taking you that in the other Asian institution, a lot of factor comes in. There will not be access. Maybe because you are pioneering. And I think I want to applaud you. So there's no question is there no need for us to also identify other stakeholders that will make it to work where everybody will see that education is not about whether you are rich or poor. It belongs to all of us. Thank you, sir.
I want to thank both of them. These are very important questions. And you can see even a link between the two questions. So many things are lacking. It's not just one. The comments by the first speaker about mentorship, these of parents and all of that. The way we mentor each other sometimes has changed. In fact, the young lecturer is even wanting to mentor them. They are too eager to. And it's true. It's true. And the senior lecturers too, and chief lecturers are not prepared. But we won't even see them. We will see them. And that's why I'm talking about some requirement. There has to be certain criteria that will force some of these things to happen on campus. That is measuring how many people have you mentored as a chief lecturer. How have you done it? There must be a way when you are evaluating somebody at that level that mentoring was the one of the things you evaluate. It's very important. And to link the idea of parents' role to the idea of holistic issues is also very important. You see, a parent will give money to their children to go to a village to go and write an exam. Medical center. And he or she will pay the money. Just tell me, sincerely, what is that parent telling that child? What's he telling that child? That it's okay to cheat, it's okay to be fraudulent. So when the child now gets all his credits and come to the university, and the child now cheated in the exam, and the child is now being expelled, should that mother come to cry on campus? So it's holistic, and like I said, you know, it's very important for parents to play their role. There's no doubt about it. Nobody is saying that parents should not play their role.
The point I'm trying to make is to focus on us as institutions. That is the point I'm making. Let's focus on that. Because my brother is talking about, give us more money. Give us more money. Yes, we need money. No, say we don't need it. But if we leave all these realities unattended to, at the end of the day, with all this money, would there be a change? Truly speaking, what kind of change are we going to have? With all the welfare and all the salary, you get salary and you don't teach. Is there a miracle that will make those students learn anything? Your union is not asking you tough questions. That look, you must be morally upright. You cannot be engaged in some harassment of student. You slap a student, for example, not still a slap a student. And you still expect your union to defend you. To go to the vice chancellor or the director and say, leave him. You know some union, they even threaten lectors, you know. Say, if you don't do this with them, you are going to pay your lab in there. And they do it. You are the one that is destroying this world. If that is what you do, believe me. Because you must always think about the larger picture. It's not about that man. It's not even about the lector. It's about this nation. Every time you fight, are you conscious of the need for Nigeria to be at the same level as other nations of the world? Are you conscious of the kind of attitude of your own members? So it's important for us to address this issue, and that's why we're addressing it. That we are asking for more money, and there's a declaration of emergency. Now, if this money comes, will it truly make a change in the resources of the world? There will be new facilities, there will be new buildings, there will be so many things. Won't corruption take away part of this money? Won't the teacher that doesn't teach, is it not able to? And there are many of these questions that we must ask. And if all these things are no, or yes, the negative side, then the money is useless. But if you use the level that you have judiciously, and you put that orientation in the system, and there is value for money, some people are coming in, they are graduating, they are happy that you have taught them. Even if you have to pay a little bit more. You know, your laboratories are working, communities, new industries are coming up because of you. New products are coming up because of you. We are using our raw materials in the world, you know, in the forest, the trees, the bamboo tree, whatever, to create something new. Look at it, we have a lot of sun. Nigeria is not a nation that has one hand like an English community. And it's happening for a lot of people. But we are the ones that have regularly irregular electricity. Everywhere we go, there's no light. Even though we have sunlight. If the laws are protecting our universities are not working, we should work and make it as a team. You know, at the grassroots level, because we are not supposed to be grassroots. I'm not saying the two want to do it and the last level. Your research should be about using same law material to create electricity, which our mothers can easily get from us. Those are the ones to use their laptop.